Hi folks, today's video is a collection of advice on how to deal with all the math and numbers in role-playing games. There can be quite a lot of math in tabletop RPGs. You're dealing with a lot of different numbers, a lot of different modifiers, having to roll different dice. And for some people, that can be a bit intimidating and might kind of prevent them from trying out some different systems or even getting to the table, as well as it can sometimes be difficult if you're playing a long game and it's getting late into the night and your brain's not working quite as well, or you're a dungeon master and you're trying to, keep track of all these different things, what the players are doing, what your NPCs are doing, and maybe adding in having to add and subtract and keep track of all the different modifiers just adds a little bit of complication that maybe you can make your life a little bit easier. So here's a bunch of tips on how to do that. The first thing is play in a math light system. A lot of the D6 systems, so Shadowrun, most of the games that Modiphius puts out, I've even seen the new Warhammer fantasy role-playing game. I'm forgetting the name of it. Let me know if you've played it down in the comments below. They use D6, and it's less about the numbers on the dice and more about rolling success. A lot of these systems, even the official dice for them, either have a plus, a minus, or some will have like a blank side. So you're rolling, it's more about how many dice you're rolling and then counting up how many successes there are. So I found that really helpful when I was playing Shadowrun, and I would actually kind of separate out some dice into sections of, if I knew I was going to need to roll this ability, this was the pool of dice that I grabbed, and I didn't have to count them out quite as much. That also requires having a lot of D6, so you may not want to do that method. But playing in these D6 systems, you're not adding the ability modifiers. Another great system that's fairly math light is Savage Worlds, and that's mostly just what die you roll, and that's the number that you go with. There's a lot less modifiers in that than in a D20 system, such as Dungeons and Dragons or Pathfinder. My second piece of advice is something to try out and see if it works for you. It may or may not. And that's when you're keeping track of your damage, add up your damage instead of subtracting from your hit points. This may or may not work. I personally found it very helpful, especially when I was a game master, adding up the damage my players were doing to the monsters and the NPCs they were fighting. A lot of those characters didn't have healing abilities that I would then have to subtract from the adding. And I just had to care about once they reached past that threshold of the hit points, that monster was dead. And I found that a lot more helpful and easier to do than subtracting. Sometimes it's a weird mental thing, but sometimes adding is easier than subtracting. May or may not work for you, but a suggestion. Also, if you're playing at a lower level and you have a much smaller pool of hit points, or you're playing in a system that just, 20 hit points is a lot, you might just keep track of them with tally marks, and then you can just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, instead of having to sit there and go, okay, I'm at 13 and I took 5 damage, that's 18. Before I get into the rest of the tips, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of our upcoming videos. My next piece of advice is to put together a cheat sheet for yourself. Now, this does involve, planning ahead, looking at your different abilities, and seeing how they kind of combine together. So put together a cheat sheet. This is especially good for, like, fighters, barbarians. If you're raging, instead of having to say, okay, what's my rage damage plus the weapon damage, just go, okay, the rage adds this bonus and the weapon has this bonus, I'll add them together and just on a sheet of paper, on some kind of reference guide, say when I'm raging and I hit with this thing, it's this die plus this number. So that way you're having to keep track of less numbers for yourself. And this goes for spells, abilities, feats, all these things. You can kind of look through and see what are the different combos I can come up with and do that cheat sheet to help yourself out. Another thing that you can do, this is great if you're the dungeon master, is just do the average damage. So for Dungeons and Dragons, the dungeon master, when you're looking through the monster manual, it gives you the average damage and then it tells you what the hit dice are to get that damage. I have done that definitely when I've been a game master, and I've got especially a bunch of little minions that I don't want to have to keep rolling and rolling and rolling and adding. I just know, okay, they hit with their dagger, it does this much damage. Okay, they did a bite attack, it does this much damage. That speeds it up, you're having to do less math, and it's just referencing that one number. Now, if you're a player and you're playing in something like Pathfinder or Dungeons and Dragons, maybe talk with your game master and see if they're okay with you taking whatever the average damage would be for that weapon or for that attack. This is definitely, you know, have a conversation, explain why you want to do that, and figure out if that's going to work or not. You do lose those, you know, awesome moments of rolling max hit damage, as well as the moments of like, I rolled a one on my attack damage. Great, I did like 2 points of damage. It takes those extremes out, but it might be enough that, you know, especially if you're less of a combat-focused group, that might just speed things up, that you can kind of, okay, we can get through combat, it's not going to be super stressful, or have moments that slow down, move things along to focus on maybe the parts of the game that you enjoy more. Ask for help. I do this sometimes when I'm a player and it's getting late and maybe my brain's not working. I also do this quite a lot when I'm a game master because I'm juggling quite a bit. If I can't look at it and figure out what the number is right away, I will sometimes say, okay, it's 15 plus 3. Yeah, that's 18, but sometimes my brain just doesn't want to do that. Also, sometimes giving out the damage to players, you can say, okay, 6, 4, 12, add it up, or just tell them what the dice are and then what the modifier is. Somebody else can help you out with that, who maybe is better with math at the table. And the final piece of advice is especially great if you're playing at a virtual table. A lot of the virtual tabletops will do the math for you. They'll tell you if they hit, they'll tell you how much damage dice it does. They'll even sometimes subtract it from the NPC's character sheet or from your hit point pool if it's, you know, the game master rolling it. Now, some of these do require setting up the kind of algorithms and the math ahead of time. So make sure you're checking on doing that, as well as some of them always don't account for like, hey, you had guidance cast on you and you wanna roll that as well. You might still have to do a little bit of adding, but a lot of those damage rolls, a lot of those spells rolls will happen for you. And if you're not playing on a virtual table, if you're playing in person, there are still online tools that you can use. I know D&D Beyond has a roller in it that does a lot of the math. And if you are going to use these tools, you know, just bring it up with the table, especially if anybody at the table has a hesitancy of having any devices at the table, and just say, I'm not going to be checking stuff, and then, you know, don't be on Twitter during the game. But this is just going to be a tool that I can use to make it easier so that I'm having more fun at the table. I'm able to focus on the things that I enjoy. Now, if you enjoy doing all the math, great. And please help the people who don't enjoy the math out if you can. But I found these things really helpful. It's really allowed me to focus on the parts of the game I enjoy, to focus on the, you know, character interaction, the role play, coming up with cool moments, the like, yes, we defeated the monster, to focus on all of those things rather than getting bogged down in the math, which can be very frustrating. And can sometimes kind of prevent people from trying out the game if they look at a sheet and they just see this like wall of numbers. It can be very intimidating. So also, you know, great tips for people starting out or people who want to introduce others to the hobby. Here are some things that you can help with those people and let them know. Don't let the numbers get in the way. This is a great hobby, and if you want to play, then we can figure out how to make it work for you. All right, so do you have any additional advice on how to deal with math and all keeping track of all the numbers involved with tabletop RPGs? I'd love to hear your comments down below, as well as do you have a favorite method that I've mentioned that you find really helpful? You know, let's help each other out. I want to say a big thanks to all of our patrons, especially Lainey. If you want to support our channel, you can head on over to our Patreon page and check out the perks of being a patron. I hope you enjoyed enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that subscribe button because we make videos here every week about tabletop RPGs and our other geeky interests. All right, I'll see you next time on Roll for Initiative. Bye. Definitely tips. I'm rambling today.